And we are back live from the E3 2012 PlayStation booth, checking out one game I'm awfully excited for later this year, Hitman Absolution. And we brought in Hacken, who is the lead producer on the game. Welcome.
Thank you.
It's been a while since the last title in the Hitman series. Why don't you bring us up to speed for those who haven't played it?
Well, it's been 6 years now, and there's a reason for that. Pretty early on in the concept phase, the ambitions we had for Absolution was pretty high with the AI, the music system, etc. And so we knew that we needed a new technology for that, and we've always done our in-house technology, and so we started a new technology called G2, and built that from scratch. So that's why it took a while with working on the technology and the game in parallel. But here we are today, and really, really proud of the technology and the game that we've created.
Now, one question I want to get out of the way right away, because I've been a follower of the series. I played several of the games, the earlier titles. There's been a bit of a, I don't know if I'd say concern, but there's been questions about whether this is an action game or it's a stealth game. How would you define that? I mean, what's your response to that?
Yeah. It was really awesome last year at E3. It was really well received with the nominations and then awards. It was Agent 47's back, and it was a bit action demo that we showed. And so the fans have been, some of them have been, the hardcore fans have been a bit concerned. Is it still a Hitman game? It's really, really nice to be here today, a year after, to show the demos we have on the floor and in the theater, to show it is very much still a Hitman game, right? And that's what we're going to see now. It's a kill sandbox, as we call it, as our fans really like it as well. It's an open gameplay. And right now, Agent 47 is to get some lead on a mysterious girl called Victoria. So he is to go into Chinatown, where he is to kill a target called King of Chinatown.
Now let's take a look at this environment. There's an awful lot of NPCs, very detailed. Reminds me a little bit of Deus Ex Human Revolution. They did something similar, but this looks like it's even on an even bigger scale. How did you guys come up with the technology for this?
Well, that's part of the technology. We've done crowds back with the blood money, and we built up on that. So it has a lot more fidelity to it now. So we can have the 1,200 NPCs on the crowd members on screen at once. With a distant density. So it's pretty cool. There you can see Agent 47 is using his instinct and can see the outline of the target, King of Chinatown, who is the middle of the pagoda there. So it's totally up to the player how he wants to go about this, right? So he could pull out his guns and start mayhem. And if he did that, the immediate crowd around him would be really afraid, and that panic will propagate to the whole level, and the crowd will just go amok. That's one way of shooting and trying to get away.
Maybe not the smartest way.
Maybe not the smartest way, but that could be fun as well, right? So, Sven here is playing to look around a bit and see if there are some other opportunities. There's an apartment up there. Now, the King of Chinatown, he has a sweet tooth for drugs. And the pusher is up there. So one way of taking him out could be go up there and get his disguise, and then go down to the King of Chinatown and trick him to follow you, and then you could dispose of him there, right?
But now, disguise is a big part of the series. Tell me what you guys are bringing to disguises now in Hitman Absolution.
It's absolutely a core part of the gameplay, the disguises. It gives the player a really unique fantasy to be able to take that and act your disguise as well. I mean, with our new instinct feature, we have put in more fidelity into that, so if you're a cop and I'm a cop, if I come too close, you can see through my disguise, we'll be colleagues, right? Hey, that's not right, you're not a cop, right? But you can use instinct, and that means that I can act my disguise. So when I go by you, I can use instinct, I talk to the microphone on my radio, like, hey, I need to go to the South Bank or something, right? And I can fool you in that way. So
that's cool. So he's Agent 47 on the prowl here, making his way closer and closer.
Yeah.
What are some of the other ways you could play this scene? Because you were telling me earlier there's quite a few ways.
There are so many ways. I mean, you can poison his drugs, you can poison his food and his favorite restaurant. You can place remote explosive at his car. You can activate the alarm, get away a safe distance, and when he gets there, you can explode him like that. You can push him into a manhole. You can trick him as the pusher down to a dark alley. You can snipe him if you find the sniper weapon somewhere in the, on the level.
It's actually a great point here while we wait for the action to kick in here. You guys have a Sniper Challenge app on PSN right now.
Yes.
Tell us a little bit about that and what you get for playing it.
Yes. Well, it's I mean, we thought we really want to give a unique pre-order incentive to you know, to our fans, and we created this Sniper Challenge very close and true to the fantasy of an assassin, right? So it's a standalone experience, game experience. So that you can pre-order the game, you get that right away. You could do that now and get it now and play it. It's a really cool level with again. Open gameplay, many different things you can discover and find and achievements, and also get the opportunity to get a Silent Assassin rating in there. And there's actually a link to the main game where if you achieve the challenges, you can unlock some special weapons that you can bring in to the main game.
So there you go, great way to get brushed up on your sniper skills here before you get Hitman Absolution. Now you guys just recently released a release date of November, correct?
November the 20th, yeah.
That's great. So here we go. We see the sniper interface. Yeah.
So
that's
let's
creepy.
See if we can pull that off. Oh, that was close. Okay, in the hip. Okay, so somebody got attention from the window when he just assassinated him. So SWAT team is on his way. So they have spotted him. So a man in a suit. So let's see if Swin can get out of the situation. He can see with the instinct that he has very keen senses, an ultimate assassin. So he can see, sense people coming through walls.
Oh, now here, look at this.
Here Agent 47 fakes surrender.
Fake surrendering.
So, there you go.
Awesome.
And takes him out there.
Now tell me a little bit about how you are, though, bringing, I mean, the other Hitman games were not known for their shooting mechanics. I mean, let's be honest. Yeah. How are you kind of bringing that, modernizing that for this game, for folks who want to take the action, the more action-packed route?
Yeah. I mean, for us, it's very important that we give a compelling experience to the players with the choices they make as a player, right? So stealth gameplay is very much in there, and it's even more with higher fidelity, as I talk about the disguise, etc. But if you want to go the more action approach, we have really upped the mechanics there as well, so we can have a compelling action experience as well.
So I take it by donning this disguise, the level of alert around Agent 47 has dropped a little bit.
Yeah. So they spotted a man with a sniper in a suit, so he took out the cop and took his disguise on. Now the whole level is in chaos. The cops are agitated and looking for a guy in a suit, but Agent 47 actually managed to put on the cop's disguise. And now he's using the radio to kind of trick them, and then they spotted him on the last minute.
Oh, I guess I got him.
So you ask about the action, you're probably gonna see something.
Okay.
Oh, there's the dealer as well.
Bam.
We also put a lot of fidelity into the AI, so we have more than 2,000 pages of script for the AI. So if you walk around the street and act weirdly, for example, do crouch or take cover or something in a place you wouldn't do, the NPCs would like look at you and say, "Hey, what are you doing? You're acting weird and stuff like that." So we have a lot of script and dialogue for the generic NPCs that really makes it feel like a living, breathing world.
And that's another thing I've always loved about the Hitman games, the way the story is unfolded through sort of eavesdropping on these conversations. I mean, are you guys kind of expanding upon that concept here with Absolution?
Oh yeah. You really get different experiences according to how you play. So if you play stealthy, you can drop into these personal stories of the NPCs, like this lady having tax problems, and you can maybe get some hints onto secret rooms or secret routes. So you get all these sub stories in that way. And the music is also very different. If you should choose to play action, it will be more like a rock style, and then the music will give you a complete different experience. That also gives an incentive to do a lot of replaying, right? I played this level in an action approach, and I got this experience. If you would replay it in a stealth approach, you will get a complete different experience with the stories and the music and everything.
Now, are there, I'm going to take a guess, are there collectibles in the game? Are there things that you can collect or discover like that?
Yeah, we have a lot of collectibles that you can, you know, for the players that really like to explore. So we have some interesting collectibles that tie into the ratings. Now, long-time fans, they know the rating is very important for our game. And it is, as you can see on the corner here, the rating are always updating and reacting to what you do in the game. So, and you know, achieving Silent Assassin is a big thing. And yeah, we definitely up the rating and challenges, etc. in the game.
More like a dead assassin there.
Right now it is, yeah.
Thanks for the demo. It looks great. Hitman Absolution coming out this November on PS3. Stay tuned. Next up, we're going to take a look at The Unfinished Swan.